śruti smriti puraṇānām ālaya bhagavatpāda śaṅkaraṁ loka śaṅkaraṁ śaṅkaraṁ śaṅkarācāryaṁ keśavaṁ bādarāyaṇaṁ sūtra bhāṣya kṛtau vande bhagavantau punah punah ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः. You are seeing that after svapna, the jiva enters into suṣupti. Okay. What is its description? Yatra supto nakanchana kamam kamayate. Nakanchana svapnam pashyati tat suṣuptam. Kamam kamayate, it refers to jāgrat. So many desires he is entertaining and he is working towards obtaining them. Okay, that is not there. Nakanchana svapnam pashyati. He is not even seeing the dreams. Okay. Tat suṣuptam. And suṣuptasthāna ekībhūtaha prajñānahana eva ānandamayohi ānandabhuk chetomukha prajñastritiyah pada. So, after giving the definition of suṣupti, now, it is here, the samashti is Ishvara, prajña. For prajna, suṣupti is the sthāna. That is just as Vaishvanara is having jāgrat is sthāna. Tejasa, namely Hiranyagarbha, is having svapna as his sthāna. Prajna is having suṣupti as his sthāna. Okay. Now, it is clear, again and again, remember, Ishvara Suṣupti Sthanam is, doesn't mean Ishvara is sleeping. Doesn't mean that. He is the samashti there. That is just as, Vaishvanara is handling jāgrat of everybody. Hiranyagarbha is handling the svapna of everybody. Similarly, Ishvara is responsible for the suṣupti of everybody. That way. Therefore, he is suṣuptasthāna. What does it mean? All this means, see, remember, when we told, jāgratasthāna, bhaiṣpragnya, sthūlabhuk, Vaishvanara doesn't do all these things. Therefore, Shastra is doing adhyaropa of my experiences on Vaishvanara. Remember that adhyaropa? Why? Because it wants to remove my adhyasa. That is, because of adhyasa, I feel I am bhaiṣpragnya. Because of adhyasa, I feel I am dreaming, etc. Therefore, to remove this adhyasa, it is being transferred to that place. How is it solved? Means, you see, I have told, but I am reminding, when I say, I am seeing external things, Vaishvanara doesn't see any external things because there is nothing external to him. But in seeing external things, there are so many processes going on. Okay. Therefore, all these processes certainly we know we are not handling. We only the end result we think we are enjoying. Okay. Therefore, when I am seeing, I say, this sentence is not wrong, but only I don't know what is this I. And after all, following the activity, I am telling I am doing it. Following the activity. Therefore, same thing, following the activity, just see the Shastra tells it is Vaishvanara who is doing. Therefore, you say that you are Vaishvanara and not this Jiva here. I think I have all been explained. Okay. Now, when you tell, when I say that I am not this body, I am Vaishvanara, and what is the big advantage? I am no longer there is no jāgrat, there is no sthūlabhoga. Vaishvanara doesn't have that. He is not bahiṣpragna. Therefore, I also cease to be bahiṣpragna. He is not a sthūlabhoga. I also am not a sthūlabhoga. I think all of you are remembering this, what I have told. Therefore, the purpose of adhyāropa is to remove my ignorance, my adhyāsa. Similarly, here also. Okay. It is my adhyāsa, remember, that I do in jāgrat, that I had a good sleep. I had a good sleep is past tense, remember. So, at that time I am not experiencing it. Similarly, svapna also. Okay. Therefore, at that time whatever was happening, I told you why it is happening, because buddhi has gone to rest. Okay. Therefore, for all that Ishvara is responsible. Therefore, I slept happily, let that sentence be all right. But I don't know. It is Ishvara, Shastra tell. So, you say it is Ishvara, I am Ishvara. But then what happens? You are no longer sleeping. That is, that I slept is removed. That sentence is removed. Okay? Are you all of you remembering? No? See, I slept is, I am telling, make this statement because of adhyasa. What is the adhyasa? I am always telling whatever buddhi does, it is I am doing. Now buddhi is keeping quiet. Therefore, I am not able to know anything. That is called sleep. Therefore, it all I have slept. That is, this statement is a result of adhyasa in buddhi. Now when I say I have slept, well, this statement, take it as it is. But I know, when I say I slept, I don't know the meaning of I. How I don't know the meaning? Because there is no connection with the buddhi at all at that time. There is no connection with the body, the manas, anything. Therefore, I am different from that. I know it from my experience in suṣupti. Though I know that I am different, now if in the morning I say, I am thinking, I am seeing, etc., then it is a wrong statement. Isn't it so? Therefore, even though it is a wrong statement, take it. Shastra, it makes the following correction. When you say, I slept, this I is not you. It is Ishvara. Okay, now I am Ishvara. Therefore, as Ishvara I am sleeping. Can you say? No, you can't say. The moment I properly recognize myself as Ishvara, I am no longer in Suṣupti. The same thing that you held in Jagrastana and Swapna and here also. Okay. Therefore, remember the clear difference between adhyaropa and adhyasa. Adhyasa is my foolishness because I don't know who I am. Now, in order to destroy this ignorance, Shastra is doing adhyaropa, that is imposing. Okay. But is this statement correct? In that case, the question is the following. In that case, I am not in jāgrat. That is, in jāgrat avastha, it is not I am not experiencing. Similarly, dream, I am not experiencing. It's not that. It's not my dream or anything. Similarly, suṣupti is also not mine. Then who am I? Have you seen this? Therefore, you are beyond all this. You are none of this. Obviously, see, you come to here, Chinmayamshan, you come here, you go back. Then you go to your shop and go back. You go to your office and go back. And obviously, though you may spend a lot of time in the office, okay, and you may spend less time in the house, and that too, when you are there, you will be sleeping. You will have no connection with the house. Therefore, your connection with the house is for a very short duration. In spite of it, I don't belong to any of these places. My home is that. Don't you say this? Similarly here, I am myself knowing that I am in wakeful state, then change to dream, then change to this, and change to dream, and change this, and changing. Therefore, I have to be different. Is it clear? I have to be different. Therefore, who is that I who is different from all these things? It is that Shastra wants to teach. So, this is the process. What is the process? Because of my adhyasa, I am telling, I am in jagrat. I am in svapna. I am in suṣupti. Shastra says, very good. But who are you? Tell me. I don't know who you are. Then what is the meaning of this statement? You don't know who you are, but you are making three statements. Oh, I'm very sorry. Yes, I understand. So, therefore, what should I do now? You not know myself? See, all these activities are being held by Vaishvanara, Tejasa and Prajna. Therefore, you are that. Okay. I meant that here. Yeah. Oh, okay. I believed you. I am that. But then, no longer I am seeing. There is no jagrat. That is exactly what I am telling. You don't have jagrat or anything. You are different from all this. Remember once again, throughout you are seeing ajñāta jñāpaka. Are you following this? Remember this sentence? It is not that you don't know this. You have to be reminded. You have to be explained. Notice yourself. See for yourself. Throughout Shastra it is this. Throughout Shastra. What it is, though it is in heart to my heart, deepest knowledge is there, I somehow don't recognize it. When Shastra points out, I recognize. Therefore, the whole Shastra is ajñāta jñāpaka. It only reminds you of what you already know, but know means you have not recognized it, though it is in your experience. Okay. Now, therefore, we told at that time, suṣupta sthānaḥ ekī bhūtaḥ, I have told. That is, everything has become one. Why? It has not become one. All these things are simply hiding in darkness. Okay. Ekī bhūtaḥ. Prajñāna ghana. that is without leaving its differences in jnana. Various jnanas are there. Knowledge of the part, knowledge of the cart, knowledge of this, knowledge of that. They are all frozen now. They are not active. So, prajnanakana. Anandamaya. Anandabhuk. Okay. Cheto mukaha. There is a long discussion on this. Cheto mukaha is what? He is the gate for all knowledges. That is, if he were not there, there would be no knowledge. Everything else may be there. If he is not there, there can be no knowledge. Therefore, for all knowledges, he is the door. Cheto mukha. Okay. Now, Bhāṣyakāra is explaining. Yeah. Then, Cheto mukha means what? Actually, it means this. He is the jñātā. Remember this, because many people are finding it some sort of difficulty. Therefore, please carefully understand. He is the knower. Who? This suṣupta-ātmā, the one who is me, myself. He is the knower. Okay? I am repeating this because many people are finding it difficult. But sometimes what happens is, if you are informed too much, you will get confused. Okay. If you are simply taking things straightforward, there won't be difficulty. Now you see, how is jñāta? He is jñāta knower means what? See this statement. I am understanding outside things. I am seeing outside things. This is Bhāṣya Prajna. I am seeing the dreams. This is Antah Prajna. That is, I am describing myself. Okay. When I am seeing dreams, I am not seeing that. Jāgrat. When I am seeing outside things, I am not seeing inside things. Therefore, I am different from both. Isn't it obvious? Is it not clear? No. Therefore, the question is, who is that I? Who is different from both these? Okay. To analyze it, you see. I am understanding outside things, keeping my eyes, ears, everything, okay? Through that, I am outside. The moment I drop them, I can't see outside things. But I have mind with me. Therefore, I can see something. What can I see? Not outside things, inside things. Okay. Therefore, in Jagrat, I was having the Jnanendriyas and the mind as my instruments, Karana, to become Bahishprajna. In Swapna, I am having only the mind as Karana for seeing the dreams. Now, I have rejected both the karanas and I am alone. Obviously, I am this here. The cook is there. He is taking the chamach and fraying something. Okay. And then he is taking some big ladle and doing something else. Yeah. Now, who is the cook? The cook is different from both ladle and this. Is it not so? Similarly, when I am free from this upadhis, but still I know I am, okay, he is the real jñāta, the real knower. The cook will say, I am the cook, but I was cooking, I am going to cook, but no, I am not cooking, but nevertheless, I am the cook. Identically here. Okay, therefore, I feeling is there. I, when I say I slept well, nakinchidavedisham, I did not know anything. Sukhamahamaswapsam, I had a sound sleep. When I make this statement, then I know I am there. And I also know that there are no connection with the karanas. Therefore, I am the jñāta. Your only question is this. But at that time I am not knowing. That is why you are the knower who has abstained from the act of knowing. You are not performing the action of knowing, but you are the actor. I think it's clear. Therefore, he who is in svapna, the suṣupti, myself, he is the jñāta. That is exactly what the bhāṣyakāra is telling. Bhūta bhavishya jñātrutvam. Once I will tell you all, if you repeat. Bhūta bhavishya jñātrutvam. Sarva viṣaya jñātrutvam. Asyaiveti. Prajñaḥ. What does it mean? Bhūta bhavishya. Or previously and afterwards. Previous to suṣupti. And after suṣupti, bhūta bhavishya jñātrutvam. There is a jñātrutva. That is, I am the knower. When I say, I am knowing, I knew, I was knowing. Who is this I? That is the question. Jñātrutvam. Sarva viṣaya jñātrutvam. It is not only bhūta bhavishyat. As a, you only here, in your house, wherever you go, sarva viṣaya jñātrutvam. Okay. Or you can even take like this. I am here, say, another person, any other person. He is also knowing different thing. They are all prajna only. Therefore, sarva viṣaya jñātrutvam asya eva. Therefore, he is prajna. Okay. Then he explains it further. Bola, suṣuptopihi bhūtapūrvakatya prajna ucchate. What does it mean? Suṣuptopihi. Even though he is in deep sleep, even though he is in suṣupti, that is, even though he is not performing the action of knowing, bhūtapūrvakatya prajna ucchate. Bhūtapūrvakatya means what? What happened previously? What is going to happen afterwards? Keeping that in view, you are calling him as prajna jñāta. I think it's clear.
Because he realizes that he is the one who is in all the three states. That is why he has to be, because he was in the first state also and the third state. It's something like
that. That's right. But beyond that we are not talking. Just now see, only jāgrat, svapna, suṣupti. It is the suṣupti person who is actually knowing our outside thing. He is the same fellow who is eating inside thing. But who is he? You can know him only when he is not acting.
Huh?
That is, he has the ability to do. The one who has the ability to do is he. Actually, he is doing it using his energy. I suppose it's clear. Okay. Now you see, next he says, Athava ప్రజ్ఞప్తి మాత్రం అస్యైవ అసాధారణం రూపం ఇతి ప్రాజ్ఞః. నౌ బి వెరీ కేర్ఫుల్. వి డిఫైన్డ్ హీస్ ప్రాజ్ఞ as prajna, who is working in the suṣupti of all. Working means who is controlling the suṣupti of all, athava, or what is he telling? Prajñapti mātram. Okay, what is prajñapti mātram? Kevala jñāna swarūpa, jñāna, that prajñapti mātram asīva, that is his asādhāraṇa rūpa. It is a supernormal feature. Asadharanam rupam. Therefore, he is prajna. Prajnapti matram. What does this mean? See, prajnapti matram, when he is telling only jnana, it is referring to Ishvara himself, not as a Sushupta Sthana. Just as, no, Vaishvanara is called Jagrata Sthana, Vaishpragna, Saptanga. Saptanga is his own feature, not mine. Have you understood now? It is this Saptanga who is handling your jāgrat, Vaishvanara. It is Saptanga Taijasa who is handling your dream. But he is not getting dream. Therefore, my adhyasa is done adhyaropa on that. Similarly, here also, prajna is being described in two ways. One, as who is responsible for the action or whatever sthiti here. And the other, him, his own. Is it clear?
Swami Mahaprabhu is speaking to Pragati Matri here. Suṣupta Atma is Pragati Matri here.
No, there is a lot of difference, because you told Prajnana Ghana. Prajnana Ghana. Between prajnana and prajnapti, there is a lot of difference. Prajnana ghana is individual knowledge just frozen. It is not like that. There are no individual knowledges. Remember this position. Be careful. Throughout this is there. If you don't miss it in one place, you can't miss it in another place also. When you say Vaishvanara, Taijasa, Prajna, in all the three mantras, there is one common feature. What is it? One part of the mantra tells about his role in me. Vaishvanara is handling my jagrat. Vaishvanara is responsible for my sthula bhoga. Vaishvanara is jagrata sthana. Vaishvanara is responsible for my bhishprajna, bhāṣya prajna. But in himself, he is saptanga. Are you following? Similarly, in the case of Tejasa also, now he is responsible for my, his svapna sthana, it's only his place. He is acting here. Na sthana. Antaprajna, he is responsible for my having antaprajna. Okay. And he is responsible for my pravivikta book, being pravivikta book. But he himself is saptanga. Similarly, Ishvara is in my suṣupti sthana. He is responsible for this being eki bhuta. He is responsible for this ananda book. But he is himself prajñapti matra.
Swami, just in case of the
previous two states.
Huh?
Here also we can say it's vyashti and samashti.
That's what. Exactly. This is vyashti and that is samashti. Have you understood? See, what, how much condensed knowledge is kept in each mantra. You should know this. Highly condensed.
Prajnanghana is vyashti.
Prajna prajnapti matra is samashti. Bahishprajna is vyashti. Vaishvanara is samashti. Antaprajna is vyashti. Not only antaprajna. Pravyakta bhok, antaprajna, svapnasthana, all this is vyashti. Svapnasthana is his. He is here. He is acting here. Okay. Similarly here, O Ishvara, he is in himself, he is prajnapti matra. He is prajna in him, in his own right. But he is acting here, being responsible for my suṣupti, being responsible for prajnana ghanatva, for being responsible for ananda book. Is this all clear? Therefore, now look at this mantra. In fact, if your head doesn't reel, you are not understanding properly. How much meaning is condensed there? Is it not so? See, in the same mantra is telling, it is referring to you, also it is responsible. For in itself it isn't. In fact, Vaishvanara, Tejasa, Prajna, all of them know that they are not acting. That's another thing. Vaishvanara knows he is Brahman. Tejasa knows he is Brahman. Of course, Ishvara is Brahman itself. There is no doubt about it. Okay. But through Upadhi, they appear to be active. In my case, because of Adhyasa, I am active. I am active. It is my Adhyasa. They appear to be active. That is their Swarupa. If you have not understood, please raise your hands. I will tell once again. See, these three are told, Vaishvanara, Taijasa, Prajna. All these three are samashti. They are saptanga, saptanga and prajnapti matra. This is samashti. They are acting here in every jiva. When Vaishvanara is acting, it is jāgrat. When Taijasa is acting, it is svapna. When Ishvara is acting, it is suṣupti. Okay. Look at this fun. There are three fellows. They are acting somewhere. Okay. And I intervene and say, I am doing it. Have you understood the tamasha here? This is a body with which I have no connection at all. See, look at this, all funny things. From your suṣupti experience, you know that you have no connection with the body. Okay. Therefore, you are nobody. Right. Now, somebody is working here. There are too many bodies. But I claim, oh, I am equal. I am this, I am that, I am telling you. Therefore, this I is, Ramana Maharshi gives this example. See, there is a marriage party. Marriage was going on. From the bride's side, there were people. From groom's side, there were people. Oh, they are all mixing, enjoying this, that, so on, so forth. And there is one very active agent. Okay. He is working. He is talking with them. He is talking with this. Everything is happening so beautiful. He is also very handsome, very intelligent and all that. Everything went on for a long time. Then some stage, and introduce me. We don't know. We haven't stood you. Yes, you are that. You are that. Who is he? Somebody asked this. And he already going there. He said, I thought, no, is he not belonging to your party? No, not yours, no. Then by the time they wanted to recognize him, he has already left. Okay, I understood. This is Ramana Maharshi's story. Similarly here, this is the Kshetra. There is a Kshetrajna. It is an action between the two. They are getting married and there is just, something is going on. No, this fellow is telling, I am doing it. Talks there, sometimes he joins there, sometimes he joins here, he is doing that. Who is this rascal? When they inquire, he is not at all there. Therefore, this I is actually in Shastra, it is bogus. It is just a shadow. It doesn't exist. It has no substance. Have you understood this? Chaya matraha is only a shadow. It's a shadow of ignorance. Okay? Now you see, same thing you understand from the point of view of Gita. In Gita, what is told? Idam shariram kaunteya kshetramityabhidhiyate etadyo vettitam prahu kshetrajna iti tadvidaha. Okay, what does it mean? Idam shariram. This body, kshetramityabhidhiyate, this is called kshetra. Why is it called kshetra? Kshetra, the word is usually used only to refer to some land. Land, a piece of land is called kshetra. Why is the sharira called kshetra? Because there is a similarity. What is that? In kshetra, you till the soil and get phala. Similarly, the kshetra used to do karma and you get phala. This is one similarity. There is another similarity also. In land, suppose there is you dig a pit. Just leave it like that. After some time it gets come closed once again. Is it not so? Because there is continuous shaking and all that, it will settle down. Similarly here, if there is a wound, okay, we just neglect it, it will be cured by itself. Okay. Of course, there should not be diabetes. That's all. Okay. Because of these similarities, it is called kshetra. Yetadyo vetti. He who is seeing this kshetra, he is called kshetrajna, the knower of the kshetra. Okay. Now remember, what is this kshetra? This kshetra includes everything that I can see. Anything that I can see. Ichha, dvesha, sukham, dukham, sanghata, chetana, dhriti, etat kshetram. Sab kuch. Okay. Now here, this body, definitely it is coming to my experience. Whenever there is some headache, this, that, so on, so I am feeling, I am knowing it. Okay. Some people claim, are you noting all the decision process? You know where this is, where that is? What is its function? No, you are not knowing the whole kshetra. Are Śankarācārya says, if you don't know it, you can know it through Shastra. That is, if you study some anatomy, you will know it. Have you understood now? Anyway, the whole body is actually an object for your knowledge. That is, you are seeing them, you are knowing them. Not only this body, you are also knowing this sthula sharira and also sukshma sharira. In Drigdrishveka, you will have frequently heard it. Okay? What is that? I am knowing all the karmendriyas. If I don't know so well as a doctor, if I study, I will also know it. Karmendriya. And all the jnanendriyas and also manas buddhi chitta ahankara. I am seeing it. Everybody knows. Oh, those who have entered rather 50 years, something like that. They all know. Young age, 40 years ago, 30 years ago, I thought I would say, there was too much of ahankara. Now it has subsided. Is there anybody who doesn't say this? So everybody is witnessing this ahankara. Everybody is witnessing this manas. Oh, manas was very good. Oh, Navaratvata, there was some vrata, all these things, it was very good. Now afterwards I saw that film, this movie and everything. Koi aaya, jagda kya, oh, bigad gaya. Who doesn't know this? We are witnessing our manas. We are witnessing our buddhi. I am not able to decide. We are witnessing our chitta. I have known it, I have forgotten. All these things. And we know, of course, our prana. Therefore, I am not only knowing the sthula sharira, but also the sukshma sharira. Now, it is universal experience that if you are knowing something, the knower is to be different from the known. The knower is to be different from the known. Therefore, I must be different from all these things. This is Drigdrishveka. That is Drishya, I am Drik. Right? No, because I am Drik means I am the Jnata. Therefore, who is the Jnata? Jnata is one who is witnessing not only the sthura sharira, but all the aspects of sukshma sharira also. Therefore, he has to be different from sthula sharira and sukshma sharira. Okay. Now you see, in my own experience, when do I become different from both? When do I get separated from both sthula sharira and sukshma sharira? During suṣupti. Therefore, when I am in suṣupti, I am the jñāta. Therefore, kṣetrajñā is identically equal to suṣuptātmā. Suṣuptātmā is also called as pratyagātmā. What is pratyak? Pratyak is inside. Inside bhaiṣpragnā there is antapragnā. Inside him there is suṣuptātmā. Inside that there is nobody, myself. Therefore, I am the innermost thing. I am the pratyak ātmā. Okay. I am the jñāta. That is, for my own entity one, depending upon the activity, different names are given. I am the seer of Kshetrajna, therefore I am called Kshetra. I am knowing everything, therefore I am Jnata. I am inside the innermost, therefore Pratyagatma. Atma, I have told, you remember that. I told even the shloka. Vyutpatti also I gave. Remember that. That is that Atma, he is the karta, he is the bhokta, he is the jnata, Pratyagatma. Atma means jnata, karta, bhokta, himself is called Atma. Therefore, that is yourself. That's why I have repeatedly told, don't look at the akasha. It's yourself. Look at yourself. If this one sentence you have remembered, you are going to remember for these 2 months, I think I have succeeded. Don't forget this. This is the most important sentence. Everybody has simply gone away somewhere. That's not correct. Atma means only this. Okay. Therefore, what does it say? Though I am different from the body, from the manas, sthula, sukshma, sharira, in jāgrat, I am associating myself with that. Therefore, when I say I am a man, I am a woman, okay, I am intelligent, I am dullard, I am rich, I am poor, all these things, and I say, it is really a wrong understanding of myself. Okay? This wrong understanding of myself is called adhyasa. Adhyasa is not somewhere happening. Adhyasa is happening here, on myself. I am the culprit and I am the victim.
This Atma, who is jnata, karta and bhokta, he is not stained by his karma.
See, while I am in jagrat, I am affected by karma. Already when I entered svapna, though I am doing all sorts of funny things, I am not connected with it. It's a little better, but I am doing. When I go to suṣupti, I am not doing anything. There is neither punya nor papa. Therefore, the worst sinner sleeps. And the most very highly evolved soul also sleeps. There is no difference at all. Are noticing this? Whether a man sleeps or a woman sleeps. Okay. A scholar, or just an ordinary man, or a fool, a madman. Whoever sleeps. There's no difference at all. Isn't that some great mystery? Therefore, as long as in jagrat I feel that I am karta, jnata, bhokta, I continue to be jnata, karta, bhokta, even suṣupti also. Okay. That is why in jagrat I have to do sadhana, I have to do vichara, and then finally understand that I am not this, I have nothing to do with the body, I am something different. Then jnātartva, kartartva, bhoktartva, all of them will go at once. Go on ruminating over these things. Ruminating means, If you go on ruminating, then you will understand what exactly I am doing. Where am I going? What is the purpose of my life? These thoughts will enter. Isn't it? So, the moment this thought enters, you are already in progress. That is the first step. I should first understand my foolishness. Okay? So, this mixing up is there, you know. What is the mixing up? Me, kshetrajna, and this kshetra, they are entirely different. Entirely different. This is the knower, that is the known. This is chetana, that is jada. And you have also seen, all the light belongs to this place. And there is only darkness. You have seen this. So much of difference is there. But in spite of it, I mix up the two. Due to my ignorance. That is called adhyasa. This mixing up is called kshetra kshetrajna sanyoga. Kshetra kshetrajna sanyoga is actually mixing these two, though they are unmixable, absolutely different. Okay? Therefore, Bhāṣyakara has defined this adhyasa in the 13th adhyaya, 26th shloka. See there. Kshetra kshetrajñayoho viṣaya viṣayinoho bhinna svabhāvayoho itaretara tad-dharma adhyasa lakṣaṇaḥ. What does it mean? These two are there. Kshetra kshetrajña. Vishaya Vishinoho, that is object and I am the knower. Bhinna Svabhavayoho, they are entirely different. But the two are being mixed up and that is called adhyasa. Okay. Now, the same thing is told in Sutra Bhashya. What is that told? The same sentence is told. Yushmad asmat pratyaya gocharyoho vishaya vishayinoho tamah prakashvat viruddha svabhavayoho itaretara bhava anupapattau siddhayam. It goes like that. That is you. This is me. That is object. This is the knower. That is darkness. This is light. Even though there is so much of difference, itaretara bhava anupapatto, you can never mistake one for the other. They are so distinctly different. But in spite of it, you are mixing the two. That is called adhyasa. Have you understood? Therefore, asmat pratyaya, yushmat asmat pratyaya gochara, when it says, this asmat pratyaya gochara is referring to this kshetrajna. That is myself. Okay? Now I have to say a little more about this prajñapti. What exactly is this prajñapti? Okay. Perhaps Perhaps you remember that, but still, well, you see here, all of you know this. This is Brahman. This is avyakrita, in which both jada and kriya shakti are there. Jada shakti means all inner things that are being seen now. The seed of all that is here. That is called avyakta. And all that kriya shakti. This is prana. Okay. And both these two, they will be latent in this. They get expressed. And afterwards it says, it gives rise to mahat. Mahat means what? Mahat was also in this. It gets only expressed. See, there is a seed in which the tree is there. Only it expresses itself after. Don't you say this? The same thing. And this mahat, ahankara, tanmatran. Now, in Bhagavad Gita, there is okay, no? Bhumirapo nalo vayuho khammano buddhirevacha ahankara iti yamme bhinna prakatarashtadha. You remember that? Okay. So what does it mean? It means, see, this avyakta mahat ahankara tanmatrani. Okay. These three, these five, I'm sorry, this five plus three is equal to eight. It is ashtadha prakriti, eightfold prakriti. This is called apara prakriti. You have known this? Okay. Now actually, the creation has to take place. This you already heard. So in order to take place, srishti take place, you need planning, and decision. Therefore, such manas and buddhi are created. This is buddhi manas. With these two things, it is Hiranyagarbha. In other words, it is Hiranyagarbha who actually handles creation. Creation, destruction, everything. That is, he is active Ishvara. He is potent Ishvara. Are you understanding this? When I say Ishvara, there is only potentiality. When I say Hiranyagarbha, all the potentiality is flowing through him. Therefore, he is active Ishvara, is Hiranyagarbha. It is for Hiranyagarbha, Puranas give so many descriptions, Brahma, Vishnu, Ishvara, all that is only him. All that. Okay. Now, remember, Hiranyagarbha is a jiva. I will soon say he was a jiva. Okay. Take it as he is a jiva. Okay. So jiva means who? Perhaps you remember, told that. Four or five people do very intense tapas, unparalleled. Even among them, only one succeeds and that becomes Hiranyagarbha. All the others lose. Okay. Now this Hiranyagarbha, he was a jiva. So with this ambition, he did tapas. What is the ambition? I must handle the creation of this whole universe. I must be the creator. I must be the sustainer and the layakarta. With this desire. Therefore, he has his own ahankara. What is this ahankara? The ahankara of a jnata, karta, bhokta. I want to enjoy. I want to do. Have you understood? Therefore, there is one ahankara of Hiranyagarbha. What is that ahankara? You say, it is called his avidya, plus avyakta. Avyakta means this, avyakarta. This avidya plus avyakarta is his ahankara. Is equal to ahankara of Hiranyagarbha. What is the meaning of that statement? Let us apply to ourselves, we will know. When I say, I am doing this, I say. You heard this. For doing anything, you need two. Can you tell what are they? Samarthya and Pravritti. Now, Samarthya is coming from Ishvara. Pravritti is coming from mine, from me. All of us know. Similarly, in Hiranyagarbha also, the Samarthya is Avyakrita, belonging to Ishvara. And Pravritti is due to his own avidya. Have you understood this? Therefore, his ahankara is avidya sanyukta avyakta. Avidya coupled with avyakta. This is ahankara of every jiva. Our ahankara is also the avyakta that is contained here. Plus my pravritti. Avyakrita also. You can take it avyakrita also. Because prana also included. Is it clear or not? That is, the ahankara of anybody is only this. This in particular, it is, in Bhagavad Gita, it is being referred to his Hiranyagarbha ahankara. Okay. Remember this clearly? Now, come back to here. There are two ahankaras now. There is one ahankara here and there is another ahankara here. The two ahankaras are very, very, very different. Are all of you following me? This ahankara contains avidya. That is, there is adhyasa in that. I am doing, it's a wrong statement. The origin of a wrong statement. Ahankara. This is one which causes pravritti. This is responsible for pravritti. Responsible for pravritti. In everybody, this is responsible. Okay. Now the whole Shastra is teaching only this. Ahankar vimudhatma kartaha iti manyate. What does it mean? He who is having mudha, this avidya, he says, I am karta, I am karta. Because his role is zero there. The whole role is, whole thing is being handled by avyakrta. Only he claims that he is doing. Therefore, that is his foolishness. Ahankar vimudhatma karta iti manyate. Are all following? Therefore, to get rid of this ahankara, whatever is to be known, that is the lesson that we learn from Shastra. Okay. So, but what is that ahankara? Okay. Now, this ahankara is defined like this. What is this? Means, mahabhutanyahankaro buddhiravyaktamevacha indriyanitashaikancha panchachendriya gocharaha. Comes like that. Now, this ahankara belongs to Ishvara. What is this? How is it defined? Just as this is defined as aham pratyaya lakshana. This ahankara is aham pratyaya lakshana. What it means, you see? To understand it, if you just try to see your own experience in deep sleep, you will understand. Now you see, as in jāgrat, you will give an elaborate description of yourself. I am so and so, is there, etc., etc. There will be so many details. In svapna also, you can give a lot of description about you. In suṣupti, can you describe yourself? No. What is the extent you will describe? You say, only I know this much, I am there. Not beyond this. Is it clear? The only description I can give about my suṣupti is that I exist. Now, in this suṣupti, the samashti is Ishvara. Therefore, aham pratyaya lakṣana means, besides telling I, there is nothing else. There is no other description. Therefore, his ahankara is called aham pratyaya lakṣana. Whereas our ahankara is so many things. There is no pravṛtti in there. Remember this? There is no pravṛtti there.
See, there is no
no pravritti.
There is no pravritti there. Remember that. Yes, that's right.
Then why do you require that for creation?
Rama. See, in Brahman, there is not even I am Brahman is also not there. Okay. From such Brahman, the Jagat is coming. How can it come? There must be a process. Now, for instance, in science you say, okay, there is hydrogen, there is oxygen. Hydrogen is a burning gas. Oxygen supports burning. From this, water is produced which quenches fire. Have you understood this? Hydrogen is there which is burning. Oxygen supports it. Therefore, when the two are together, they will start burning like petrol. But you get water, when you put a stick, it will get quenched. Okay. Therefore, how can it come? When you say, oh, then scientists will explain. There is a valence bond, whatever it is called. Okay, then you join this. Then you will get this. It is because this, like this, therefore fire is put out. They will give some explanation. Have you understood now? Similarly here, from that sort of Brahman, where there is not even I, if this Jagat should come, how should it come? Therefore, the first thing that has to come is, I will do. I should come. Will do na, I should come. That I, how does it come? Just because this valence bonds here. Here it is because of prakriti it comes. With this prakriti, the same Brahman is called Ishvara, who will say, I. This Ishvara also has no pravritti. Therefore, he creates another I, Ahankara, who wants to do, I will do. I will achieve. I will see it is done. Say. Therefore, both ahankaras are necessary. Okay. Remember this. There are two ahankaras involved. That is the most important thing you have to remember. The ahankara of Ishvara, in which there is no pravritti. The ahankara of Hiranyagarbha, in which there is pravritti. What is the difference? In Ishvara, there is only prakriti. And it is that prakriti itself is samarthya for Hiranyagarbha. But in Hiranyagarbha, there is something more, avidya. Therefore, this ahankara is actually responsible for the action of creation.
Swami,
Gita
Kishan Ji, Kishan Sarmaji,
I did
that, I did this.
When I say I did this, he is referring to Hiranyagarbha. When I say Maya Adhyakshana Prati Suite Saracharam, he is referring to Brahman. He tells both. See, everything is happening by me, everything is happening by me when he says, it's not that he is having a lot of ahankara. It doesn't mean that. It is not this type of this. I will tell you. There were two high school friends were there. They were very close. Okay. Then they went away. Distance, what happened? Oh, nobody knew. Suddenly after 35, 40 years, they came to know. Okay. Oh, you are here. Oh, you are here. You are the same thing. Yes. Oh, you are there. Come on, come on, come on, come on. This man is some good teacher somewhere. That man is a millionaire. Okay. Ray, what is all this? This is my wife. This is my first son. This is my second son. This is my daughter-in-law. This is my house. There's this thing. Is it ahankara? It is giving information. He is not boasting. He is simply giving information. Okay. For that matter, when he says, I am doing, he does not have ahankara. Because Hiranyagarbha himself, when he was born, he had ahankara. He had done a lot of tapasya and he got the position. But then his tapas was so great that he realized that he is Brahman only. Therefore, he lost his ahankara. He is no longer having ahankara. But he has only ahankara vasana. That is why I say, if you take every word into account of Shankaracharya's bhāṣya, then only you will understand. Ahankara, it's alright, it's alright. If you skip the pages, you don't understand. That is why Shankaracharya says very clearly, ahankara vasana vadavyaktam ahankarityuchyate. Ahankara vasana. That is, what is ahankara vasana? Somebody gets jnana. He has become a jnani. After, even though he has become a jnani, he has really no ahankara. When people ask him, come for bhiksha, he will come, go there. And somebody will ask, where is this temple? Are you going this there? He uses the word I, but he doesn't have ahankara. Have you understood now? It's only as a formality, he says. Therefore, Hiranyagarbha, though he started with ahankara, he lost his ahankara. By prarabdha, whatever he has to do, he is doing. Therefore, it is ahankara vasana, not ahankara. In the case of Bhagavan Krishna, it is not even ahankara vasana. It is only ahankara, that ahankara.
Because in Ishvara there is no
prarabdha,
Ishvara is not born.
Yes. Ishvara has no prarabdha. All of you followed? Anima?
Can we say that the origin of the first born lies in the ahankara of Hiranyagarbha?
Exactly.
Origin.
The first origin there. I want what I am going to do, he said. In fact, in everybody taking the into the vyashti, I will do the first thought that comes. Okay? Therefore, prajñapti mātra means what? Ahankāra lakṣaṇa. Aham pratyaya lakṣaṇa. Is there no? That is prajñapti mātra. Just as in suṣupti.
I know I am.
No, I not that I know there at that. I can, there is no I there also. But when I want to describe it, I can't describe more than I existed. Similarly, Bhashyakara gives the meaning is, itarayoho vishishtam api jnanam asti. That is, itarayoho means, in Taijasa and in Vaishvanara, there is vishesha jnanam. Vishesha jnanam means what? Qualified jnanam. This jnana, that jnana, all those things are there. Whereas, in suṣupti, there is no viśeṣa jñāna. So, when you say prajñapti mātra, what does it mean? It means, it is without viśeṣa jñāna. Actually, it is Brahman's jñāna only, not different. But Ishvara can be described just as much as I describe myself in Suṣupti. How do you describe Ishvara? Ishvara was there like that. Then with respect to himself, I have arrived, I. Okay? So in every Purana you will see, if something nonsense happens here, all Naradas will all go there. And he says, all this nonsense is happening, don't know what to do. So, don't worry. Everything will be alright. Okay? So everything will be alright means what? I will set it right. Because Hiranyagarbha is very impartial. Okay? He will manipulate what is to be done. Okay, now he is active, whereas behind him there is no activity. That is why Shastra says, though Ishvara is Sarvajna, Ishvara is Sarvajna, Sarvashakta, but in order to do creation, what does he say? Anena jivena atmana anupravishya namarupe vyakaravani. What does it mean? Means, I will enter into this jiva form and then I will create. The question is sarvajna, sarvashakta, is everything, is omniscient, omnipotent. Why should I depend upon this lesser fellow? Anena jivena atmana anupravishya? Because he has all the ability to do prakriti, avyakrita, but he has no pravritti. Why he has no pravritti? He has no avidya. There is no pravritti. But srishti has to be done. Why bother about? He says, there is one fellow who wants to do it. Let him do. Who is he? Hiranyagarbha. He is there. He wants to do, after all, let him do.
greatest problem is to remove avidya. It is coming to Hiranyagarbha. But then we have removed that avidya. Why is it coming?
No. He has removed his avidya. Did you not remember this? I have told he has removed his avidya. How can that avidya come from there? It is not there at all.
So for creation it has to be.
For creation is never, for the creation he does, it was necessary, it is not there. He lost it. Similarly, you also do.
Vasana is there.
Huh?
Vasana is there.
No. That vasana is not there. See, that's what he told. Question is, remember this question. See? Though ahankara has gone, ahankara vasana is there. Ahankara vasana is also not there. But if I want to describe, I will do it. For instance, okay, Ramana Maharshi was there. You take a typical example. Certainly he was not karta, bhokta, anything. Not at all. Okay. But when he is going from here to there, how do I say? How do I describe? Yes. He is going. He is eating. Now he is sitting there. Now he is speaking. Don't I say that? That is, I am imputing kartrutva, all these things in him, though he doesn't have. Have you understood? Similarly, when Bhashyakara says he is having ahankara vasana, what he means is this. What he means is, activity is being done. Therefore, he is doing the activity. He is creating. He is protecting. And he is destroying. I mean, there is some kartrutva is attached to it. That kartrutva I am seeing, that is called ahankara vasana. It is only outsiders describing it. He is not having it.
Okay, who is the karmapaldata? Hiranyagarbha?
Actually, karmapaldata, Hiranyagarbha. All activity is handled by Hiranyagarbha. All activities are handled by Hiranyagarbha. If you are feeling some discomfort, understand it like this. The samarthya for that is coming from Ishvara. Therefore, Ishvara is doing. This is Adhyaropa. When we say, don't we say, the creation is being done by Ishvara. We don't say Hiranyagarbha. Yes. See, that's what I'm telling him. Huh? Though actually the job is handled by Hiranyagarbha, he is responsible. For instance, this building is there. Who built it? Oh, so beautiful. Say, nobody shows the mestri. They show only the malika. Is it not so? Similarly, here also, actual handling is Hiranyagarbha. But you say, oh, only Ishvara. You show Ishvara.
And that is why in Bhāṣya,
that Pesha Annam. That's right. Okay?
Duality. Duality.
Let it be. Where were you worrying about something else? Go on seeing it. Don't you see the duality is gradually reducing? Then what? Let us wait. Okay? We'll stop here. Bolo. Shruti Smriti Puranam. Thank you.